1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
We are the first in Missouri to have the Neosys Yomi dental robot. It largely hasn't been much of a marketing aspect. The whole purpose of taking it's a sizable investment in the equipment, the whole purpose of that was to ensure that the patient care is as optimal as possible.
It's been an incredible asset. Implants go in fully guided, and we get incredibly predictable implant dentistry with it.
Landmark achieved.
What we do first is we take a CT scan x-ray of the patient. We put that into the software. Then we're able to place a virtual crown or the tooth for the implant. And then we base the implant actual, which is the prosthetic root, we base that location on where the crown of the implant is supposed to go. We plan that in the software, we lock that in, and then the physical side comes in when we're actually manipulating the robot and using it, that when we get situated in the patient's mouth and we get to that location where we're placing the implant, the robot knows where we are in space. It locks in the angulation of the drill, and it will not allow us to deviate from that, from a side to side direction, a forward, backward direction, and then it also will not let us insert the implant too deep, which is important because some parts of the mouth have vital structures that we don't want to traumatize.
Yeah. So the virtual planning is incredibly neat. The patients like to see that too. One of the most impressive features to me about the implant robot is that it's haptic. So the patient moves, the implant robot arm moves with the patient. So there is literally no margin for error there.
How did this come about to where you all had this to help out with your procedures?
Yeah, so the robot's been around for a few years, but not in a wide market release. So I've been aware of it for quite some time and was waiting to find out when it was available for purchase. And we got that information spring of last year, and then we purchased it and started using it in July of last year.
Yeah, it's been an amazing addition to our clinic, and I'm not going to lie, I was a little skeptical at first, but it's been an incredible asset. Implants go in fully guided, and we get incredibly predictable implant dentistry with it.
How's the reception among people getting procedures? How's that been among them for the most part?
It's been great. People are excited about that. Some people are interested in the technology aspect of it. Other people are more interested in the fact that it makes things a lot more accurate and it removes any margin of error compared to a lot of people who place implants. They do that freehand, so there's a lot of margin of error, whereas with the robot, we fix that, there's no margin of error. So it's just each person finds their own, you know, value in the technology.
Yeah, my patients absolutely love it. They usually have a lot of questions, but they're always very fascinated with it.
What are kind of like, you know, maybe the short-term and long-term goals with like having a robot like this? I don't know if it'd be able to expand, do more than what it's doing now, or if that's kind of been explored, or if you're, you know, pretty content with like, you know, how it's helping out with the implants currently.
Yeah, so the robot itself is focused specifically on implants, but it was originally FDA approved for implants, individual implants, like for an individual porcelain crown for that implant. But recently, there have been some advancements in FDA approval to allow that robot to assist us in doing larger implant restorations, like for some patients who need to get a full mouth worth of implants to rehabilitate the teeth. It has software features that allow us to manage that completely within the robot as opposed to relying on some third party and then going back to the robot for the actual insertion of the implants. We can now do all that with the robot system.
Yeah, and they are constantly evolving their software too. Recently they came out with alveolar ridge reduction that's going through approval now, correct?
Yes.
Yeah, so that will actually help where we don't need a lab fabricated guide and we can actually use the robot for precise reduction of bone.